the latest in breast cancer treatment and prevention, plus top dietitian and SpiceRack author Rachel Beller on the foods that could possibly reduce your personal risk.
Now, from Times Square, DeMarco Morgan and Eva Pilgrim with what you need to know.
A wall of breast cancer diagnosis impacts approximately 1 in 8 women in their lifetime. There are many ways to take control of your own health and reduce your risk, starting with the foods that we eat.
That's right, and here to break it all down for us is dietitian and author of SpiceRack, Rachel Beller. We're
Rachel
so happy
to
have
good
you
to
here,
you.
Rachel.
So great to be
okay,
here.
Okay, so we got to start with this because we have to mention no diet can prevent breast cancer fully, but a healthy lifestyle can certainly reduce the risk. So when we're talking about what we're putting into our bodies, one of the things you say we need is fiber-rich foods.
Yes,
why?
Yes, fiber-rich foods are very, very important because they help us with hormonal balance. They may help us remove excess estrogen from the body. It supports weight management, our gut health, which in turn supports our immune system. So this is really, really important. The key thing to think about is how much. Mm-hmm. So for breast cancer risk reduction, I recommend 30 to 35 grams per day. And the best recommendation I can give is to start your day off with about 10 to 15 grams in the morning, and that gets you well on your way. So the strategy is important.
Trying to get it all in.
And these are some of the options right here.
Yeah, so we have some high fiber foods right here, and then what I have here is my AM Fiber Boost Mix. We want to keep it simple, especially those undergoing treatment also. We want to keep it simple with simple strategies. So it's a combination of ground chia seed, ground flax, and oat fiber. And all in one tablespoon gets you about 5 grams of fiber. And you can add it to your overnight oats, to any breakfast meal, and you're good to go.
Love it.
And you talked about starting the day with fiber. So what do we have over here? How do we move on and keep that fiber going?
Yes. So for lunch and dinner, it's important to be more inclusive of plant-based proteins because they're rich in phytochemicals that protect us on the cellular level, anti-inflammatory properties, and fiber, which we just talked about. So this is great. These are great examples of protein, plant-based proteins.
But is it more of a challenge to get plant-based protein versus animal protein?
No, it's all simple and convenient. We've got tofu, tempeh, any kind of bean here, edamame, very rich both in fiber and protein. So, and it's also very budget friendly.
Nice, and I say that because sometimes you feel like you have to double up when it's plant-based.
Yes, yes, but there are ways to do it, and in my book, Spice Rack, I explain the portions and how to make it happen with ease, with ease.
What about spices? And let's talk about spices. Right. What kind of role can they play?
Spices are incredible. I fell in love with it based on the research, thousands of studies, and they're such a simple way to elevate the nutritional value of your meal, sneak in those antioxidants, anti-inflammatory properties. So what I have here is the Bella Nutrition Everything Savory Spice Blend. You've got to smell this. It's got sweet paprika, garlic, turmeric, black pepper, and a pinch of cayenne. It's not hot spicy.
It's not too hot.
No, not at all. And it goes on almost anything. And the way I incorporate it here is with this no recipe recipe, which are these everything savory spiced chickpeas.
Those are good. Simple. I thought they were going to be crispy, and they're not. They're soft, but they're delicious.
It depends how you cook them, but it's great. And this is an all-in-one, or you can make your own. It comes with the book. We have that at bellanutrition.com. It's great.
So we talked a lot about prevention, but for me, suggesting items for treatment when patients are undergoing that treatment, what do you have for you?
Yes, it's very important to support people during treatment. They need simple strategies, and what I have here, a common side effect is nausea. So this is an anti-nausea power tonic. I include fresh mint, fresh ginger root, fresh turmeric root, Ceylon cinnamon, and black cumin seeds. This really helps with digestion. It helps us really soothe us. It's very soothing and comforting. And you can have it chilled, you can have it warm, just simple and easy. And then during treatment, we think about needing extra protein for muscle mass and also for tissue repair. Very, very important. And a lot of patients will ask me, Rachel, what can I take to treatment? I need something that's energy boosting and great.
I was about to ask about that.
Yeah.
The energy. A lot of times it's low energy when you're going through.
Yes, but they want to feel empowered with good ingredients. So these are my protein energy bites right here.
Already.
Yeah.
That's all you had to say.
They're great.
Love an energy bite.
They're great frozen. Love it with a power tonic.
Well,
it
has,
yeah, it's got protein rich hemp hearts, and we've got ground chia and ground flax. The ground basically helps us with digestion. So it's great.
These are great.
Yeah. And it's all in the book with the spices. We have it on special. And
this is good, too.
This is very good.
Right? I'm glad.
Let's give it up one more time for Rachel, everybody. Rachel, thank you so much. And by the way, you can scan the QR code below to purchase a copy of her book, Spice Rack.
With all of this great information inside. And when we come back, what about going tech-free? What you need to know if you are having trouble putting your phone down.
We're listening. Plus, he co-wrote, produced, and stars of the funny new film, The Problem with People. Paul Reiser joins us here in the GMA3 Cedar with the